everybody, what's up? It's your boy, Kelvin Christopher, aka DJ Kells, and welcome to season 10. That's right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, season 10 of Wadadli 411. And yes, you guys are not accustomed to see me, but my boy TJ the DJ, I'm filling in for him because he's stuck in New York because of all the hurricanes and storms that passed. Speaking of storms, this show today, tonight, whichever time of day is for you, is going to be one of great interest because we'll be talking to a few key people that actually experienced the disasters that happened over the past few days, weeks here in the Caribbean. All right. And also, here with me tonight for the first time ever and with that the 411, my girl, Koshia, aka
Kojo
Josiah. Welcome, Kojo, to the show.
Thank you. Right? Thank you.
And
happy
Kojo,
to be here.
Get used to this face. Get used to this face right here. All right? Yeah, so we got a great show tonight. Tell the people who we got lined up.
Okay, so tonight we have, or today, whichever time you're watching, we have Senator Zizali, who will be giving us some insight about, you know, what donations would be accepted for the citizens of Barbuda who were directly impacted by the tropical hurricane. By Hurricane Irma. We also have Drastic, who was affected by the storm directly. He's going to tell us a bit about his experience and also about some stuff that he's working on as an Antiguan music ambassador.
Yeah, the artist Drastic,
So happen.
Yeah.
Them island boys.
Definitely can't wait to hear what he has to say, especially with the experience that he went through.
I mean,
in Tartola.
I can only think about it. Like, and just thinking about it, I can't imagine it. Like, you see the pictures, you see the videos, you hear the stories, and you're just like, wait, what happened? It's too much for me.
Yeah, it's like a dream.
God knows why he spared us. I couldn't deal.
But I'm sure the folks out there can't wait to see it. So we're going to go to a quick commercial break. We'll be right back to Wadadli 411. Don't touch that dial. Stay locked to whichever station network you're watching right now. Boom.
Hey.
At Living Spaces, you can get items for personalized living. Create a space that's unique to your lifestyle. Largest selection of mattresses. Choose from a variety of styles to bring out the beauty in your home. Amazing deals for amazing furniture. Best price guaranteed. Living Spaces, located on Old Palm Road, St. John's, Antigua.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Wadadli 411. This is the part where we thank all of our sponsors because, you know, without them, this show would definitely, it wouldn't be possible. It just won't be possible without our lovely sponsors. And my lovely co-host is going to list out a few sponsors for us. And Kojo, what's
So first we have La Bussola, which is a top scale Italian restaurant. I hear that they have pizza and beer night on Tuesday nights. So you can go take your girlfriend out, take your boyfriend out, take your friends out, you know, it's a good chill night.
Yeah, definitely. And they're located over in Coolidge, Dutchman's Bay, right? And they used to be located over on the northern side of the island, but now they're relocated over to Dutchman's Bay. A lot of people don't know that.
Yeah.
But if you go straight to Coolidge, past the airport, past the army base, the old army base, going towards Defense Force, you make a right, head to Dutchman's Bay, follow the sign, and their food is awesome.
Or you can look for it in Google Maps.
Google
Maps taking over. We also have Island Provision, who sponsors all our drinks. You know, my mocha that I've been sipping on for the show.
It's lovely. And have you ever tried the shaker energy drink before?
I haven't, but I probably will try one tonight.
The party maker.
Yes, I heard awesome. That has in like the same alcohol level as beer or something like that.
Yeah, well, actually, it's 4.5%. and of course packing all the other elements that makes an energy drink an energy drink.
That sounds like I'm not going to sleep if I drink that tonight.
You
so I might
won't.
Drink it maybe on Saturday. Maybe I'll try one on a Saturday night, maybe.
And of course, you know the nutritious Tiger Malt, Banks Beer, the ever famous Banks Beer.
Yes.
Pepsi, 7-Up, good stuff, man.
More Banks.
Good stuff. All right, who else we got sponsoring us, Kim?
We have VCMG Media Group.
Yeah, that's Viva Caribbean Media Group.
Yeah.
Right? That's without us, I have to say us, because we are Viva Caribbean Media Group. This show wouldn't be possible. Mm-hmm. Period. Who else do we?
We have Tempo Networks, which mostly we may be watching us on right now. So big up to Tempo.
Big up to Tempo Networks, also HPTV and also Vibes FM HD.
Yeah.
Right, channel 100 and Flow.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, so let me list out a few of other sponsors. Mm-hmm. After this show, we're hungry. Right now we're hungry, guys. We're starving.
Hungry, girl.
And we have some delicious, new, thriving Chinese food waiting in the back of the studio for us. And oh boy, oh my gosh, I have roast chicken. I have, what do you call that? The garlic fried chicken wings.
You have spring rolls.
No,
you didn't get any egg rolls for me?
No egg rolls today. Maybe next week.
Next time.
Yes,
let him know.
Yes. Okay. Let me make sure we got the egg rolls coming in. We got the Cantonese fried rice. Oh, Chinese grub, man. The best on the island.
Searching for the perfect getaway for a luxurious and tranquil experience? Royal Retreat offers spa treatments such as manicures, pedicures, facials, waxing, massage therapy, also special events and packages. Our services are also mobile. We come to you. Call us today at 785-7636. We're located on Lower Long Street, opposite DHL. Open Monday to Sunday, 9 to 5. Royal Retreat, providing luxury is what we do best. Gift certificates are also available.
Welcome back to Wadadli 411. It's your girl Kojo, and we are here with Drastic.
So what happened?
So I heard you're making moves as an Antiguan music ambassador, and we're also proud of you. Could you tell me some more about what you're doing?
Currently, you know, I'm just working on I'm doing a soca dancehall EP that I'm working on, that I hope to release in 2018. I got a couple of music videos we're looking to release. The song that I'm pushing right now, Oye. We're looking to release a music video, but you know, the situation is, so we got to take a pause for the cause, return back to that, refocus, get it back on the way, you know. I got a song, Love Come Down, produced by Andrew Blacks out of Jamaica on the Obsession Rhythm, that I'm also looking to release later on in the month. Looking to do some benefit concerts for some of the victims of the Hurricane Irma that just passed. We also acting as a liaison for people trying to get in contact with people in the various places. So it's a lot going on right now, and trying to, you know, balance the music with just everything, the relocation. It's because everything has just happened so suddenly.
Yeah,
so it's kind of trying to get my foot back on growing and figure out, like, yeah, you know, because a lot of the plans that we had pretty much got halted, you know, like stuff that you don't have any hard drive, any computer, we don't even know if it's still there. So, you know, we still got to go check up on those things there, so, you know. But I recently got to the finals for this Uber Soccer Cruise, so with the song, same song, Oye. So I'm looking to, you know, continue, win that competition, represent.
Give us a piece of Oye. For those watching who may not know what the song sounds like, give us a piece.
I mean, say, turn up the sound, turn up the kit. Every girl wind up your body for me.
Hey.
Every girl shake up your body for me. From your full of shape and your back planted. You know that's what I like, just what you did. Do it for me, one more again. Love all your baby, don't change a thing. Go wet your off, miss it, the chain. Just push back. Aye. Every girl a swing that body. Aye. You know.
Okay, so now y'all know. Tell us about the Uber Soca Cruise and the...
Yeah, you know, just go to their Instagram page and and almost the Instagram page on Instagram. Just go to the Instagram page, it's Uber Soca Cruise. Mm-hmm. You're gonna see the three artists, them look for Drastic. Oh yeah, it's the artist with the most likes that gets selected to go on the cruise and represent his country.
Okay.
You know, so we want a local go far.
So Antiguans, you know, we're asking you to go on the Uber Soca Cruise Instagram page.
And it's also on their Facebook.
Okay, so Instagram or Facebook.
You can repost it if you want. If you have the repost app, repost it.
Get your friends to like it. Get your friends to like it.
Broadcast
they're trying
it
to get
WhatsApp.
Antigua on that cruise.
Let me check it.
Okay, so you were telling me about how Hurricane Irma just basically came in and just mashed up everything for you and your family. Tell me a bit more about, you know, your experience during, because I know the BVI got hit hard.
Yeah.
Tell me more about that.
It was a I Am Legend, Armageddon meets Walking Dead type movie in real life. So it's like, it's just a different thing to live it. Irma, last thing we heard about Irma, I think it was a category 4.
Yeah.
We lost signal to the world probably 6-8 hours before the storm reached. So I didn't even know when it reached or if it reached Antigua. I didn't know Barbuda was hit.
Yeah.
But I did get, you know, pictures of St. Martin. And we saw the pictures and the videos from St. Martin, you know, your heart sink because it's just like, this thing is heading straight this way.
Yeah.
You know, and the houses that we were in, well, our houses, it's like reinforced glass and doors. We didn't have enough time to board up a button because people really didn't. I don't think we expected it to like hit us because the last thing I swear we heard is that it was going north or northwest and then it shifted last minute. So, you know, but we decided, my wife and I decided to stay in the house. We have the landlord upstairs, she's 71. You know, so we didn't really want to leave her alone by herself either.
Okay. Yeah, that was a good move.
You know, we stayed in the house and we watched the ocean just come up in the house. It's a lot of glass too, so we had to sit down and just watch it, you know.
Wow.
So from the tornadoes to just, it was like like you're under underwater aquarium.
Oh.
Except it's like Irma was just throwing like just heaps of water just back and forth against the glass, and the glass was just shaking in and out, and the earth was shaking the entire time, like a constant earthquake. And it sounded like wind turbines, like jumbo jets just hovering over you. It's just I lived through Lewis. I don't remember all of that. You know, like this hurricane was a total different ball game. And we got winds up to 225 miles per hour gusts. You know, it ripped through Tortola like you drop a bomb and detonate it and just wipe out everything.
Wow.
That's literally how Tortola looked. You know, we sat in the kitchen area because I felt that was the safest area in our, if we needed to make a run to the bathroom or to run into a closet, because I was being realistic and I knew that it was going to come through.
Something might happen, yeah.
You know, and as soon as I said that, I got the bags, I just had the feeling because it was getting near to the eye. And we watched the glass like come in like that and just explode out. And shards of glass just came straight out of our face.
Oh my gosh.
You know, and this is adrenaline because it was like slow
motion.
Yeah,
and you had the baby too. So all these things going through your
mind. Exactly. She had the baby in her hand, you know. And it's like, you know, you see it in slow motion, like you see the glass break and like separate, and it's like I grab her and the kid and run into the bathroom, push him in the bathroom, grab a couple of stuff, lock the bathroom door, and I had to brace against the bathroom door until the eye reached.
Okay.
You know, and you could hear the destruction outside in the house, just everything just ripping apart, all the glass them breaking, all the doors, the windows, the doors them flying off. And you know, when my wife could see, we watch each other and we could see, you know, we were both pretty terrified.
Scared,
but
yeah.
I didn't have time to like be scared,
exactly,
you know.
Exactly.
So
you have to act.
Yeah.
So. At least you're a fight more than a fright. Because
you know?
Some people get scared and just freeze in all of that. I don't know what I would do. I don't know. Honestly, I just don't know.
But it was the most stressful thing. Like if it was you alone, you know, me alone. Cool. I run in the bathroom. I'll be cool. But I got worried about my 2-year-old son and my wife, you know. So in the eye, we ran upstairs to the landlord, checked her out. We struggled to open up the door, went in. Same situation in her spot. You know, everything just busted up. But she has a pantry.
Okay.
So we hid in the pantry. weathered out the rest part of the storm. And when we stepped outside after that storm, like I said, it's like somebody dropped a bomb.
Like everything was gone.
Debris everywhere, all the roofs them gone. So like, I would say 90% of the houses down there are gone. So you have a lot of homeless people, and then they started looting, and there was water shortage, food shortage, and there was no service, no radio, no Wi-Fi, yeah, no telephones, and so it was a little chaotic, and we didn't see any police for a couple of days. And one of my boys, Swain, he's in my group, you know, he performs with me. He walked from Sage Mountain, which is the highest point in Tortola, to come and look for us to see if we were alive, which is like probably like an 8 mile walk, and Tortola is hilly, so it's not flat.
Oh God.
And then you're walking through just non-stop muck and debris, yeah, and just, you know. And he got to us and we went with him and we found his mom down in Humptum's Gut, which is like from Willie Keys to Five Islands.
Oh wow.
And then it's like, we find his mom, okay, found her, my wife's grandma, who lived further up the hill from him, and her house was totally trashed, like her bedroom was totally in, the roof's gone. And,
oh, wow.
And you could see people on the side of the road on the journey, collecting, you know, what's remained, whatever they can salvage. Then we went from the grandma's house to her mother's house, which is now like from Five Islands to, I don't know, Jabberwock, you know? And we had to walk, everybody was just walking to find their loved ones, and there's electrical wires everywhere, and you just, and then you know that people are acting, like I said, it's like Walking Dead, so you have to watch out for people trying to rob you and all that stuff,
exactly,
you know? Like,
yeah.
So when we got to a supermarket one day, and they had a line, and we camped out at the supermarket because we heard they were going to open. We didn't have no more food, so we camped out there, got some Wi-Fi, and that's when my signal came in, and started seeing all the messages pouring in from people back here in Antigua. And Claudette Peters, she called me. She was hysterical on the phone. Super Diamond was on the background. They're all hysterical. And they're like, you know, we're trying to get you out of there. And several people, you know, was working on getting me out of there. Omari Harrigan and my mom and my dad, they're up in Canada, but they were trying their thing. And they were just like, look, whoever first gets him out of there, whatever works, get him and his baby out of there. We need them out of there now.
Yeah.
You know? And we were on the way to her mom's house because Hurricane Jose was on the way now.
Yeah.
And we were like, we can't take that. Like, absolutely, like, absolutely cannot not. Take
yeah,
that.
Yeah, you have to, you know? Yeah, get out.
Yeah, so, you know, we started packing because now I'm like, I'm doubting that we're going to get evacuated, but still there's hope in my mind. So I'm like, I don't know if everybody's filling up my head with this madness or is it really going to happen? So we're making preparations to move to her mom's house for Jose. Plus, we're packing in case we have to evacuate. And on the way to her mom's house, she saw one of her coworkers, and he told us, "Yo, there's phone signal on the west side." So we drove over to the west side, and it's a difficult drive because there's a lot of cleared the road, but there's just still, you know.
Yeah.
And we got over there, and as I got signal, it was just to get to the airport now. And I'm looking at my phone, it's 4 o'clock, and they're like, the plane leaves at 5. And I'm like, oh my God, like, what? Like,
yeah, so that's a rush.
My heart, like, sang. It's just like, what? But then it's like adrenaline is like, yo, okay.
You have to go.
I put on the phone and just turn on this gas, you know, up back to her mom's house to get the kid, grab some stuff. We left the groceries that we got with her because they didn't have any groceries. And we didn't even get to tell the landlord we were leaving. And we just headed straight to the airport. Hazard lights on, beep, 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 like a game of chicken. Like, whoever's in the road had to come out of the road.
Fast and Furious type stuff.
Yeah, you know? And we got to the beef island, that's where the airport is, and it was like locked off because the UK military is there. So the UK military had just landed to come into the island, and they're sending two ships over, and plus there's 10 more fleets coming, you know. So, you know, he asked us for our IDs, explained to him what was happening, and he told us to go through, and I got off of the island with Caribbean captors. And even getting to the airport was very scary too, because you just see military men and you get to the airport and the airport's closed, nothing's happening. Right. So it was like, what's the evacuation plan?
Like, what's happening?
You know? and there's a curfew for 6 p.m. and it's now 5:55. And it's like, what's happening? Nobody knows what's happening. And finally, this guy with a sat phone shows up and makes some calls, and he's like, hey, there's a plane coming from Antigua. Digital people, so I'm assuming that that's your plane. You know, and there's like 14 other people. They're trying to get evacuated, people from St. Lucia and other spots. And one of the planes turned around. So you just had people stuck there because the plane that was supposed to go to Puerto Rico turned around. They have kids, and so everybody's trying to get on the plane. And we finally get through security, and it's still just like, yo, is this really happening? Like, you know. And then I see Colin Moraine, that's my boy from high school, and he's the pilot. So, you know, he comes over and he's like, Drastic, I wasn't gonna leave this island without you. He's like, I got a text from your cousin.
Well, that's good.
And they were like, yo, you know, Drastic? And he's like, I didn't even read the rest of the message. He's like, I knew what to do, you know? And they had, like I said, other people outside. So there was a family of like 7.
Wow.
And he didn't want to leave because the plane's half empty, you know? So he got, only 5 of them could have come on the flight. So he took the 2 kids and three of the adults, and they had to leave the rest behind, you know? And we got out of there, we took off, flew over Hurricane Jose. Hurricane Jose was like 10 miles to the left, so you could have seen that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That must have been something.
What? You know, and flying over the other islands, you could see Virgin Gorda look just like Tortola, destroyed. You could see Anegada, destroyed. Joyce Van Dyke, destroyed. But, you know, there's good news still, because despite all of that, you know, things have been put back in place. The UK military, as I said, is on base. They're helping the citizens. There's relief programs. The supermarkets are now open, some of them, and they would have regular supplies, so people don't have to really worry about necessarily starving.
Yeah.
But it's going to be done in an orderly manner.
Okay.
And some of the ports, I think, are open back. All the information is actually on my Facebook page. So if anybody looking for information, even if you're trying to get Antiguans out or just trying to find out anything about anybody, there's a lot of information on my page, facebook.com/teamdrastic. Just go there for all the information. Send me a message, I respond, because we've been trying to get a lot of Antiguans and Barbudans out of the areas affected by the hurricane. So, but that's difficult too, because it's like 8-seater planes and you have like 40 something people over there.
Yeah, I mean, everybody wants to get out.
And everybody wants to get out. And you have to get clearance from the military, and you know, so.
Well,
I'm just grateful I'm here.
Exactly.
I'm so thankful that the hurricane didn't hit here, because then it would have been like leaving from nothing to come to nothing.
Exactly. I mean,
yeah, so,
God knows why he's spared Antigua.
Yeah.
He knows.
Yeah, so.
But thank you for, you know, sharing your experience with us. And just going to remind the public again, it's Uber Soca Cruise, right?
Yeah, Uber Soca Cruise.
Instagram and Facebook page.
Yeah.
And we're looking for Drastic. We're trying to get Antigua on the Uber Soca Cruise. I think that's all the time we have now. So thank you again for coming out and talking with us. That would be a
pleasure.
Okay, so guys, there you had it. It's Drastic.
So happy.
Keep it locked to Wadadli 411.
Relocated on the beautiful Dutchman's Bay, Antigua, is La Buzzola.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella. Hearts will play tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitar and when the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool, that's amore.
One hasn't lived well sleep well, loved well, if one hasn't died well. Labu Solar Restaurant on Dutchman's Bay.
We're just here for the fun, gonna drink some rum, gonna party all night long. When I wake up in the morning, I give thanks for another chance for me turn up. Living my life in the moment, that's how I like it. Feel it revive right now. Living my life in the moment, that's how I like it. I miss it, turn up the sound, turn up the kid. Every girl wind up your body for me. Every girl shake up your body for me. From your full of shape and your bad flaunted. You know that's what I like, just what you did. Do it for me, one more again. Love all you are, baby, don't change that thing. Go where you are. Push back, push back, push back. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Every girl a swing that, swing that, swing that body. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Girl, let's go.
Relocated on the beautiful Dutchman's Bay, Antigua, is La Buzzola.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella. Hearts will play tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitar and bella. When the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool, that's amore.
One hasn't lived well, sleep well, loved well, if one hasn't died well. Labu Solar Restaurant on Dutchman's Bay.
Welcome back, everyone, to Wadadli 411. It's your girl, Kojo. And here we are with the Honorable Senator Aziz Alik. Not trying to get it wrong. We have her in studio with us today. She's going to be shedding some light about the big bad monster, Irma, that came and totally destroyed our sister island, Barbuda. So she's going to be telling us how we, as Antiguans, can help out the Barbudans who lost everything. And also she's gonna be, you know, encouraging us to take a more positive approach towards the situation. So Aziza, how are you doing tonight?
I'm good, Kusha. It's nice to be here with Wadadli 411.
Okay, so tell us about how we can contribute. I know they've been getting a lot of contributions. So I know a lot of people, you know, some people have been jumping in, you know, have totally taken responsibility and said, okay, I have this, I have that, you can take this, you can have that. What do the Barbudans still require?
Well, I must say, starting that, Antigua has really embraced our sister island in this trying time. You know, it's been 1 week since Hurricane Irma passed, and she was a Category 5 plus. A lot of people didn't even know that existed. Mm. She's been one of the biggest storms on record. And in that short space of time, we had the mandatory evacuation that the Prime Minister, Honorable Gaston Brown, implemented. That was necessary because we know we had Hurricane Jose coming after, and we didn't know what was going to happen in that regard. So we basically had to evacuate everyone in Barbuda and bring them over to Antigua. So to basically have absorbed them in Antigua. And then they say, you know, life works in mysterious ways, because if reversals happen, Antigua would not be able to have been absorbed by Barbuda. So we're here to help our brothers and sisters in Barbuda, and I can say in the past week, the response has been overwhelming, not just locally, but internationally as well. Mm-hmm. Antiguans and Barbudans in the diaspora. And it is going to take, Barbuda needs to be rebuilt. Mm. And it's not something that's going to happen overnight. It's something
definitely
that's going to take
not
a very long time. Mm. And you have these people whose their whole lives has evaporated
exactly
in front of their eyes, and which is it's a traumatic experience. Imagine that everything you know
just disappeared overnight.
Your livelihood,
your clothes, all your makeup, your shoes, everything.
Makeup
gone.
And shoes.
Okay.
So it is definitely a very traumatic experience. So what we have as Antiguans to assist in Barbuda is in that their day-to-day needs the things they're going to always need. Anything like deodorant and things like that, and soap and toiletries and toilet paper, shampoo and conditioner. For women, things like panty liners, sanitary napkins are very important. And cleaning supplies, because a lot of them are housed at shelters now. We have Stadium is a shelter, the NTC is a shelter as well, and then others in private homes. Mm-hmm. And so things like discipline and Clorox and mops and buckets, mm-hmm. are things that are going to mean that you may not think is important. Toothpaste and stuff like that. So it is we have to think about the day-to-day needs of the Barbudans and also their long-term needs. But I think it's important that we as Antiguans have to think about their mental health. This is a traumatic experience, so most likely a lot of them will be suffering from PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. Mm-hmm. So so it's not just about physical things they need, about their mental health. And how are we going to make sure that a lot of them, they want to go back to Barbuda. And sometimes you see comments sometimes, people are ungrateful. But you have to understand these people's lives were taken away from them in a few hours. Not even, she moved fast through Barbuda.
And then they had to leave a few hours later. So, I'm sure a lot of them didn't even get to evaluate the damage.
Yeah.
They didn't get to do a walkthrough of their property and, see what they could salvage and,
Yeah. So a lot of people are attached to things that we may think is trivial. So there was a situation where a woman was talking about cleaning her fridge. And people say, why does she want to do that? But you don't know if that would provide her some peace of mind to do something that's normal to her. Because these people, they're in Antigua. Some may have never been to Antigua before.
Exactly.
Or some may not have family here. Mm-hmm. So it is a situation where we have to understand that they're in a traumatic experience, and we have to find the best way to mitigate their pain and to help them adjust. And eventually, and we also have to help them rebuild Barbuda, because they're going to eventually want to go back home. Right. And that's something that the Gaston Vaughan administration will be dealing with in the next couple of months, next couple of years, is that we want to rebuild Barbuda better than it was before.
Definitely.
And in a responsible, environmentally friendly manner. Because Barbuda is known for its beauty and its pink sand beaches. So we want to be able to build houses that can withstand strong storms, and houses that are green, environmentally friendly, and so that we even though we make a Barbuda, we improve certain things, we don't lose the essence of what Barbuda is.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So what are some of, I'm gonna ask this question first. You said, I'm thinking about the children, mm-hmm. who now have to go back to school. But I heard that the school over there is completely destroyed.
Yes, secondary schools.
They would possibly have to be enrolled in schools here in Antigua.
So the Ministry of Education, the Honorable Minister of Education, Michael Brown, so they had meetings with recently over the past couple of days about that. So the children would be put into our school system, mm-hmm. in Antigua, and they're going to need
books, rulers, pens, pencils.
So those are sort of things they're going to need. We do have the uniform grant system, so I assume that will be assisting them in terms of the uniforms. But they're going to need, kids. Kids take a lot of stuff. Kids
are
expensive.
They're going to need,
they're going to need school supplies. So that's something that we can help assist as well. And there's some who are going to need to stay in Antigua with homes and things like that. Mm-hmm. So we need to offer up our homes. A lot of people have done that. My family has offered up their home as well. And a lot of Antiguans have it just really impressed me how we jumped to the task at hand. There wasn't any delay. As soon as we've heard that the issue is in Barbuda, we just went with it. The Prime Minister went over, and I think that was no better. I think that he did a really good job in terms of leadership, that he himself went over to see the damage and to talk to the Barbudans
and
reassure them.
That was a really, really good move.
To reassure them as the leader of our Twin Island nation. So I think that was something that
it needed to happen.
It needed to happen instead of delegating
because,
it to someone else.
There was a lot of talk about, why did he go over and it's so soon after? But he needed to see. He's the Prime Minister of both Antigua and Barbuda.
And I agree. And there was it was a long time before, because we lost our communication with all the cell. A lot of the cell towers were destroyed. The ham radio was destroyed. Mm-hmm. I remember him leaving a satellite phone with them for communication purposes. So it was really, he saw with his eyes the damage. that. And when you heard him speak, he said, you know, it really moved him. He's never seen anything like that. Because we've experienced hurricanes in the Caribbean that have, you know, caused damage. A lot of us experienced Hurricane Lewis in 1995. The older persons would have experienced, you know, Hurricane David, Hurricane Hugo and whatnot. But I think, like, just from watching the footage myself, I've never seen anything like that. And so it's, and Hurricane Irma has caused destruction, not just in, but across the Caribbean, you know, yeah. In the BVI, you know, Tortola,
Anguilla, St. Martin.
And other countries have it worse in terms of, you know, law and disorder and things like that. Yeah. And I say we are grateful that.
Yeah, Barbuda, at least they have, you know, somebody to fall back from. They have Antigua.
Yeah, so. Not just to fall back, but we didn't have a situation where it turned violent or anything like that.
But I think because the Prime Minister acted so quickly,
yes.
Like that situation was completely out the window. Like there wasn't any time for anybody, you know, to think, okay, I'm gonna start robbing people, you know, because it was hurricane, go over, see what's happening, okay, let's bring them out, everybody.
Yeah, I can say the swiftness that was the situation was dealt with, I think could have mitigated any negativity,
exactly.
Or any violence that could have happened, mm-hmm. Over there. So it's going to take a long time to rebuild Barbuda. There was a meeting last night, Monday, with the Barbudans, and it basically, the Prime Minister said, this is something that will take in excess of $250 million.
Yes, exactly.
To rebuild this
an
country.
Entire country. Yeah.
You're basically rebuilding an entire
schools,
country.
Hospitals,
homes, and
clinics.
And then the different initiatives. There was he discussed about land ownership and stuff like that,
yeah.
And tied to these. So that's going to be very important for Barbados to not just say they live there, but to own a piece of the rock,
uh-huh.
which is something very important.
Exactly. Okay. You also mentioned the traumatic stress that the Barbudans were going through, and how we as Antiguans need to be a bit more sensitive towards this. Tell us a bit more about that.
Yeah, I think we need to understand that this is a once in a lifetime experience. When I have a gentleman from Barbuda with us, and to hear him talk, he has flashes of the experience, and he remembers certain things of helping a child,
yeah.
And so it's a very traumatic experience,
yeah.
For them. And sometimes certain things are going to be said that we may not understand, but we have to be understanding of it to know, okay, these people lost their livelihoods and their way
they
of living.
Everything.
And we have to understand that sometimes they're going to say something, or sometimes we may not understand their mindset,
mm-hmm.
But also they are going through a traumatic experience, and we have to provide them with the resources that they need to deal with it.
Exactly.
Whether that be counseling or just be a listening ear,
mm-hmm.
Someone might keep telling you the same story over and over,
mm-hmm.
And you may be like, oh, I'm tired of hearing this story, but you have to understand that that might be their way of coping. So it's for us to be not just understanding, I'll say, of their physical needs, but of their mental needs as well.
We really need to be our brother's keeper at this time and look out. So any which way you can, donate, whether it be monetary, whether you can buy, you know, some sanitary napkins, some deodorant, some school supplies to help, you know, a Barbudan child who lost everything in this horrible, horrible storm. I mean, we were fortunate in Antigua. God knows why he spared us. He spared us so that we can have an opportunity to help those who need to be helped. Okay? So thank you, Senator, the Honorable Senator Azizi Lee, for coming out tonight and being in studio with us. You know, you shed a lot of information towards the public, and I think everybody right now is feeling a bit more emotional and compassionate, you know, towards
I think that's one of the most important things that we need to understand. Because not everybody, as I said, it's a long process. So there are people who might not have the financial means to help the Barbudans, but you can find other ways to help them. You can take a visit down, you know, one of the shelters, mm-hmm. And say, okay, what can I do to volunteer? Can I volunteer an hour of my time?
Can
I volunteer?
Time, money, goods,
you can volunteer half an hour of your time, mm-hmm. to help. Done multi-purpose, there are a lot of clothes that need sorting. If it is that you can't financially donate something, you're in a, you know, a tough bind financially,
exactly.
Go down there for half an hour and help sort some clothes. Whatever little way you can help, benefits everyone.
A little goes a long way.
Yes.
Okay, so thank you again for coming out with us tonight.
And it was a pleasure, Coach, to be on Wadadli 411 with you.
Hey. Okay, everyone, you're watching Wadadli 411. Keep it locked. Okay, everyone, it's been a packed show. We had Drastic, we had the Honorable Senator Azeez Lake. You know, you heard about our sponsors, but now we have to go.
Yeah, it's goodbyes for now. You know, it's been fun.
It's been a lot of fun,
unfortunately, we had some sad news, and it was really exciting to hear the experiences. Especially from Drastic.
Yes,
he was. That was really drastic when he went through with his family. You know, I know it saw it happen. Yeah, so, I mean, while he was speaking, I was picturing everything in my mind.
Me too. I was trying to be there with him.
Yeah, and it felt like a movie.
It felt like a movie. It felt like one of those Terminator films, you know? Kind of movies. You
Actually,
know?
Ever seen Where? The movie Tornado? Or tornadoes.
I don't think I've
ever seen a movie with a tornado. They have so many tornado movies on.
I know.
And it reminds me of that adrenaline rush you get running from a tornado. Mm-hmm. And
it's just scary. You know, but at least we can try and move forward now. We can try and build and get some sort of normalcy back.
Right. And with Azeez Lake speaking on Barbuda situation and rebuilding Barbuda. You know, with every bad comes a good.
Exactly.
I think this is an opportunity for us to bond closer with our brothers and sisters over at Barbuda.
And you know, one of the positives we can take back from this is how everybody, not only just throughout the region, but throughout the world, has been reacting and trying to help however they can.
Yeah, you know, and that's really awesome to see the unity.
It just brings us closer together as humans.
Yeah. Right. And I mean, I feel it for the other islands too, Tortola, the BVI, the USVI, St. Martin, having all the looting and all of that
it's
stuff.
Crazy.
It's crazy. And the stories, it's unreal. it's really unbelievable what they're going through. Where can the people follow us?
For those of you who are interested in watching more of our videos, you can follow our YouTube channel, Wadadli 411. And if you're already watching on YouTube, don't forget to like and subscribe. Our Facebook page is facebook.com/Wadadli411. You can also follow us on Instagram @Wadadli411.
All right, there you go. And by the way, it's /.
/, yeah, not backwards.
Internet. Always. He's forward slash.
There you have it.
Forward. Right? Guys, definitely don't forget, tune in next week. Same time, same place. One love, Kushir, first time. Season 10 of Wadadli 411. The Big 10. So, yes, we got more to come next week. Stay tuned. Love you guys.
Bye.